In this video, we're going to talk about the process of executing another workflow within your n8n workflows. And that process is largely handled by the execute workflow node. Now, you can find that node up here. You just add a new node. You're going to type in execute, and there it's going to be execute sub workflow. So if you click that, it's going to give you the option of executing a sub workflow. You'll also notice that there's a trigger. The trigger is when executed by another workflow. Now, this is the one that you're going to need to have set up in the workflow that you're going to be calling. So let me go ahead and show you that, or at least an example of that here in a moment. So here I have a research report writer that I've written, and you'll notice the very first node, the trigger node, is a when executed by another workflow. So I click on that, and inside you'll see that we have some information here. And this information is, what is this node expecting to receive? If this node does not get this information, it will not run. And that's how these guys work. You need to make sure that you're passing the correct information from whatever workflow you're operating out of to the workflow that is being called when using this when executed by another workflow. All right, now there's a couple of different ways to do this. You can either define the fields like you see I have here. All right, so I have, you know, previous conversations, user request, session ID, timestamp, and user ID as fields, and I've identified that they are strings. I can change that to arrays or numbers or whatever, and to, in order to ensure that the data is being passed properly to this workflow so that it can run properly. Because if this node was not here, this whole agent would not be able to run. That's a complicated agent. It would not be able to run because it's not getting the data it needs in order to be able to have the input it needs to do the thing. So you can either have that set by field, or I'll show you another example. Here's another agent that I have that has a when executed by workflow node. This one I have a JSON example. And so that's the other option that you can do here. You can do fields, JSON example, or accept all data. Now I'm going to tell you, when you do accept all data, maybe it's just me, but I have yet to be able to get a sub workflow to work when I use it. It just won't process the information at all. It just won't do it. So I don't know what I've done wrong, but I either use the I use the fields or the JSON example in order to get these things to work. And in this case, the JSON example lays out exactly, you know, here's my JSON. I've got, you know, here's one field, here's another field, 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 and field. And then it'll show me what it should look like over here. All right. And so in order to get these to work, in order to be able to call another workflow, you either need this node inside of your workflow, and it's going to ask you inside of here, you know, it's going to ask you, what source are we using? And so I'm going to use my database of workflows that I have. And so I choose database, and it's going to ask me which workflow, and then I get a list of all my various workflows, and I just pick the one that I want. And then when I pick the one that I want, it will then let me know, okay, well, this workflow over here, right here, requires these pieces of information in order to be able to process. So then you would then fill in each of these, and then it will be able to pass that information properly so that your sub workflow can work. Now, if for some reason, maybe one of these items is seeking a number, but you upload a string, you can try to have it change the type in order to be correct by turning this on here, the attempt to convert types. Now, you can also change your mode. I have it run once with all items. You're gonna have it run once for each item. And so that's if you have different items coming in, you can either have it all do it all at once, try to take all that information, just pass it once to your sub workflow, or you can have it run for each item that comes in. So it just depends on how your workflow operates. You have some other options in here. And the other option is to wait for the sub workflow completion. And generally what it's going to do is your workflow is going to plod along until it gets to this point that it runs the sub workflow, and then it's going to wait. And it's going to wait for that whole other process to finish. And it's most likely going to wait for a response from that sub workflow. And once it gets the response, it'll then pass forward and continue on and be able to operate further. Now, you don't always have to do that. You can have turn that turned off, in which case, once this activates the sub workflow, it's then going to then go to the next node and continue on with your process. If you are going to pass information to a sub workflow, you do need to send a response back. Maybe not with these guys, not with this particular node. If you're going to use an AI agent, though, we'll come here, create an AI agent, and we're just going to do a define below. It doesn't really matter. Okay. You can call sub workflows straight out of an agent. In order to do that, you have to set a tool. I'm going to click the button here. And we see here it says call n8n workflow tool. This is essentially an execute workflow node just as a tool. So you click that. You're going to give it a description of what the tool is. And then you'll see our source is the same that we had before, a database or a JSON. You can pass a JSON code, and that will be however you want to code it to then call the correct workflow that you have. But I would just use database. And then you choose the workflow. In this case, we'll do report writer. Come down to report writer again. Choose that one. And same fields. It's going to ask me to input that same information. But here in the AI node, at the very least, I can have the AI figure out what each of these is supposed to be. And I'll have the AI input that information rather than hard coding it in or passing an item from a previous node. I can now make this part of my process where the AI figures out what needs to go in it. But I do need to add a description. If you don't add a description into this tool, it'll break. It'll break every time. So call this tool to write reports. You know, it doesn't need to be particularly complex, but it does need to have that information. And then all we would do is make sure you have your chat model, give it a system prompt to be able to understand that it has access to this tool, what the tool's for, what information it needs to pass. And then the AI agent would be able to call a tool. And the benefit of using the AI agent is you can stack up the tools under one AI agent, just give it another one and another one. And now your AI agent is supercharged. It has access to all kinds of different workflows within your system, and it's able to process it. Now, that is one way to do it. Another way to do it would be like here, where I have, this would be what I call a manager agent. So I have an operator agent that would call this manager, and it calls it here. You'll see I have a when executed by sub another workflow node. And in this case, I have it set for a JSON example of what the output should look like, or what should the input should look like. I'm sorry, the input should look like, and then processes it. It decides which branch it should go down, and then it sends that information through to my AI agent, which structures an output to then send to my execute workflow node. And in this case, it would send it to something like this tools agent that I have. It would just be one of my email agents. And so they would have email tools. Same thing, it would have a JSON example that it gets. It processes it, it uses the tool. It then responds back to my AI agent, letting it know that we have completed the task. Here's the information that you need. That information then gets passed to my next agent that then continues my workflow for me. And so those are kind of the two processes that you need you can do here. Either you can build an AI agent that has access to these tools like this, or you can build kind of a flow that then calls the tool and passes the information on to the next stage. Either way, just understand that AI agents, if you overload them, they're going to have issues handling their tool calls. I like to do one thing at a time with all of my bots. So instead of having the AI agent have the tool here, instead I would set a structured output parser where I require it to output the information a very specific way. I pass that very specific information to my execute workflow node, which passes it to my sub workflow that then processes it the way it needs to, and then it calls it back and continues on. I could have made this a tool that then would have just jumped over here and given it to the next AI agent. In my process, but that's not how I do it. So that is how you use the execute workflow node. If this was helpful, please make sure to like the video, subscribe to the channel, share the video. That stuff really does help. I would really appreciate it if you did that to help get this information out there to those who need it. Also, if you want additional helpful n8n tutorials, or if you'd like additional workflows for your n8n accounts, please join my free school community. The link is in the description below. I have social media posting bots. I've got scrapers to get data so you can grow your business and make sales. I've got personal assistant bots, AI agents for emails, calendars, all that stuff. Just lots of cool stuff in the community. Great group of people all focused on building AI into their businesses. As always, I'm Bradford Carlton. Let's automate your success together.